So really, it's just a case of, again, going into the world file and bringing in the next set of applications. So I'm going to go for KDE next. Might bring in, let's try LibreOffice and these media ones as well, these sound ones and video. Let's see what that brings up. Okay, some changes that got to be made to package use. So these again are obviously updates that are required. So KDE frameworks. Not there. So is that kite models needs QML? There's another one here, prison, which also needs QML, so I'll add that one in as well while I'm here. And the last one is this UPnP requires IPv6. Right now I don't use IPv6, so that looks like it says if VLC needs it through the UPnP use flag. So if I edit, have I got VLC on here? No, I haven't. Okay, so I need to add media video VLC, media video. Just need to add in that UPnP, and I don't want it, so put minus in front of it. Oh, looks like there's another news item there actually. Let's have a look at that first. Alright, okay, so it's about the XORG server, so that's not going to be a problem. Just get rid of that. And just do an update. You can see it's about the e-login D thing. So that's already been taken care of. That should all work as soon as I reboot. Now, it may have been possible to bring in all of the world packages, but by doing it a piece at a time, there's probably some mitigation against packages not installing. So you've probably got a bit more control over it by doing that. All right, so I'll let this go and see how long this one takes as well. Right, so that's finished with a couple of failures by the looks of it. Let me just check the messages first. Office. Oh, let's see this arrow here. So it looks like it retried yet. Oh, LibreOffice didn't install because it requires Redland, and Redland failed to install. Yep, okay. So, I mean, there shouldn't really be any configuration changes necessary with these packages, because unless there's anything new, because in theory most of them should already exist. Things like this I'm going to take a copy of. If I decide I want to install them, we'll just check that they're all installed. Just improve functionality. I'll take a note of that. I can't remember whether I've changed that or not. They've changed the default action as a task switcher. I'll have to test that to find out whether I've noticed it's changed or not. So my prime objective is just to get the system back to how it was originally. With all the updates, these extra optional things, they might already be installed. But I can check that later. That's not really the objective of this project at the moment. Configuration files, like I say, they shouldn't really need changing. Yeah, I don't think I'm going to keep these. Oops. So I'll get rid of that one, because I don't want to change the display manager. And the other one I've got to check is the NTP client. Oops. And that's just to do the configuration, so yeah, I'm not going to adjust that either. So just need to look at this Redland. Oh yes, I remember this now. This had some sort of weird problem, a previous version. and I had to manually patch it. So what I think's happened is the patch still exists and I need to remove it. It's not part of the e-build, but because I've manually added it, it includes it. Yep, so February 16th last year. So I'm going to move. I think there's the only one there actually. Yep. I'll just move it into my root in case I need it on another machine, but I shouldn't have thought so. Now it's a year out of date. So now I should be able to install, Redland should install, and that means that LibreOffice should install as well now. Let's see if Redland installs. Yep, that's fine. So I'll just wait for LibreOffice to compile and install now. Right, so that has finished now, so that means that we're up to date again with the current world set.